हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ मीनल नेरकर फ्रॉम कंप्यूटर डिपार्टमेंट AISSMS इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी लिंक लिस्ट एंड इट्स टाइप्स. लिंक लिस्ट इज मोस्ट कॉमनली यूज लीनियर डेटा स्ट्रक्चर विच कंसिस्ट ऑफ ग्रुप ऑफ नोड्स. इन लीनियर डेटा स्ट्रक्चर डेटा एलिमेंट्स आर अरेंज्ड इन सिक्वेंशियल मैनर. ईच नोड कंसिस्ट ऑफ two fields, that is data field and the address field. Okay, data field contains the information. It can be integer, float, character or of any type, whereas address field is containing the address of the next node in the list. In linked list, the elements are not stored in continuous memory locations. Okay, they are scattered in the memory. Then there may be question that arise in your mind ki how the nodes are connected to each other. That's the reason why the node contains address part. With the help of this address part in the current node, we can move to the next node in the linked list. Array data structure makes use of static memory allocation, means memory is allocated at the time of compilation. Restriction of this kind of memory allocation is we should know in advance how much memory is needed. As opposite to that of array, linked list uses dynamic memory allocation, means memory is allocated at the time of execution as and when needed. That's the reason why we don't need to know the size in advance. In array, insertion needs shifting of all the elements one position down from the position where the element is to be inserted, and deletion needs shifting of all the elements one position up from the position where the element is to be deleted. Okay, no such shifting is required in linked list. Insertion and deletion operations can be performed easily. Okay, data structure such as stacks, queues, graphs and trees can be easily implemented using the linked list. Disadvantages of linked list: memory is wasted as address needs to be stored. So for storing address we require extra memory. Elements of linked list cannot be accessed randomly. It has to access each node sequentially. If we lost the address of the first node, we will lost the entire linked list, as first node contains the address of the second and second node contains the address of third and so on. There are three different types of list: singly linked list, doubly linked list and circular linked list. We will see each type of list one by one. This is singly linked list, consists of three nodes. As explained earlier, each node contains two fields, data field and the address field, which we are calling it as a next field, as it points to the successor or the next node in the list. First node is allocated the memory of 6000. First node allocated the memory whose base address is 6000. So this base address is stored in the first pointer. Okay. Now the second node is allocated at the address 5000. So this 5000 is then stored in the next field of the first node, so that the first node and the second node will get linked to each other. In the same way, the memory is allocated for the third node whose base address is 2000. Okay. So if we store this 2000 in the next field of the second node, the second and the third node will get linked to each other. Now, as this is the last node, this node don't have any successor. So, we are storing the null pointer in this address field. Null pointer implies ki it is not pointing to any other memory location. In order to traverse this particular linked list, we should know this base address of the first node. If we lost the base address of the first node, we will lose the entire linked list, as the first node contains the address of the second, second node contains the address of the third. So this is the drawback of the linked list. Why it is called as a singly linked list? Because if you see, we have maintained the pointer, okay, which points to the successor, okay, and this is one directional pointer. We can traverse using this pointer, okay, we can traverse the list only in forward direction or in single direction. So that is why it is called as singly linked list. Okay, other reason is, if you observe the node, in the node only one link is maintained, which is the forward link. So that is why it is called as the singly linked list. Now, if we want to implement or write coding for this, how we can write? Okay, so as you know, the structure of the node is this. It contains the data field and the address field, and that address field is pointing to the entire node. Okay, so that is why this is the structure. Okay, class node, and it has the two fields. First is the data field and the next is the address field, okay, which points to the node. Okay, drawback of this singly linked list is what? We can traverse the list only in one direction or the forward direction. We cannot traverse the linked list in reverse direction efficiently. Okay. So to overcome this particular drawback, there is a concept of doubly linked list. In doubly linked list, we are maintaining the forward pointer as well as the backward pointer. So forward pointer helps us to find out the successor of the node, and backward pointer helps us to point to the predecessor of the node. So as we are maintaining the two pointers, forward pointer and backward pointer, that is why it is called as doubly linked list. We are maintaining the two links. If you observe the node structure in case of the DLL, okay, one extra field is there, okay, as compared to that of the SLL, that is singly linked list. Okay, so this field is used for storing the data, this field is used for storing the address of the successor, and this particular field is used for storing the address of the predecessor. Okay, so that is why the structure of the node is this. If you want to implement the DLL using some code, so the structure of the node of DLL is like this: class node, and in that node it contains three fields. First field is the data field, second is the pointer to the next node, and the third field is the pointer to the previous node. Okay, this is nothing but the doubly linked list. Okay, what is the advantage of the doubly linked list? We can traverse the doubly linked list in forward manner as well as in backward manner very efficiently. Advantages and disadvantages of the doubly linked list over singly linked list are: it can be traversed in both the direction, that is forward as well as the backward direction, very efficiently. Okay, the delete operation and the insert operation can be performed efficiently. Okay, disadvantages of DLL are: it will require more space as each node has one extra pointer, okay, which points to the predecessor of that node. So for storing the link, extra memory is needed. Okay, and the number of modifications increased while doing various operations like insertion, deletion, etc. As you need to update the two links instead of single link. Over here, if you see, this is the last node and it has no successor. So we are storing the null value over here. In the same way, the first node has no predecessor, so the prev pointer will, or the prev field, is storing the null value. Okay, there is no point in storing simply null pointer. So the idea for this gives the idea for implementing the third type of linked list, that is circular linked list. Why can't we use these fields? For some other reason. Why to store, or why to waste the memory for storing the null value? Instead of null value, okay, in circular linked list, what we are doing is we are storing the address of the first node. Okay, so if you observe over here, this field, instead of storing null value, it is containing the address of the first node. Okay, so that is why it is called as circular linked list. Okay, we can traverse this list in a circular manner, as and when we reach to the last node, from the last node we can again go back to the first node and we can start traversing the list again. Advantages and disadvantages of the advantages and disadvantages of circular linked list. Advantages are: the list can be traversed from any node, okay, as it has no null pointer. Okay, we can easily traverse its previous node in a circular linked list, which is not possible in case of singly linked list. Disadvantages of CLL is: if not traversed carefully, then we could end up in an infinite loop, because here we don't have any null value to stop the traversal. Thank you.